I want to talk about something real quick, and that something is exercising your dog. So with a lot of people, what they think is they think they need to take their dog for a long walk, and they need to do like extensive, like multiple walks a day or something like that in order to exercise their dog. And that's just simply not true. You really do not need to take your dog for walks in order to exercise them. Right now, the way that you do this, the way that you exercise a dog without walking them is training them. And that's the thing that kind of goes over everybody's head is you could, by teaching your dog commands, you can get them, you know, you can exercise them. So if I were to say, Kosh, come here, come on over, get over here and heel, come on, heel, no heel, no heel, come on, sit. Right, so you teach your dog to sit, and then you can teach him to lay down. Right, Kosh, get down. No, down. Come on, dude. Quit dragging ass. Lay down. Right, so he's laying down now. Now, if I were to say, Kosh, sit, that just exercised him. All right, go ahead. Right, so I just released him. But basically, when you teach your dog how to sit and lay down, and then you have them sit and lay down a lot in quick succession, your dog is doing push-ups, right? It's the exact same thing as if you were to go and start doing push-ups. And that's something that just, it goes over people's heads. I mean, I just talked to a friend of mine. We had a pretty long discussion about dogs, and he's a fan of Cesar Millan, and I don't have necessarily any issues with Cesar Millan, but Cesar Millan really hammers about exercise in your dog when training is more important than exercise is. They are both very important, but really exercise is sort of a supplement to training. You will train your dog and they will get exercised while they're being trained. That's the general idea. This is the basic idea of retrieves. And it's weird because, you know, people are too lazy to train their dogs, but having a trained dog is perfect for the lazy owner, because the lazy owner with their trained dog, they can exercise their dog without doing shit. Right, all they have to do is say something and then their dog will get exercised, right, as opposed to them having to go on a long walk. Now, I think that you should go on walks with your dog. I think going on walks with your dog is a good thing, but the thing is that it's really not a substitute for training. And that's the thing, is a lot of people, they really don't grasp this, they don't understand this, and it's really like just a shame. And but basically exercising your dog is just, it's not as important as training your dog. And that I just gave you an example, you know. Koshka, hey, knock it off, quit eating grass. No, no, get over here, come on, heel, get over here and heel. No, heel, come on, heel. No, heel, come here, quit fucking around, sit. He's eating grass. Don't let your dogs eat grass, by the way. They can't digest that shit. It's too much fibrous plant material. People say that it helps with your dog has a stomach ache. Your dog shouldn't be having stomach issues, because you should be knowing what your dog is eating, right? But basically, you know, don't let your dog eat grass. That's not all right. But yeah, I mean, like, just kind of to, you know, to wrap it up, what I was saying is just, you know, there's a million different things that you can teach your dog and exercise them, right? It's pretty much all training is exercise, right? And that's the thing, is like, if you teach your dog the place command and you have them go to place and come to you, that's exercising them, right? And then doing retrieves with your dog is also exercising them, right? So, and Koshka loves doing retrieves. If I were to bring him right over here, Koshka, come here, come on, buddy, come here. No, sit. Good boy, sit. Koshka, sit. Sit. Koshka. Right? You just went for the retrieve. That's exercise. He's getting exercise right now. He's running, he's going and picking up the ball, and then he's gonna bring it back to me. Right? Like, as we speak, that's what he's doing. Come here, bring over here. Come on, dude, here. Bring it over here, heel. Sit. No, sit. Hold, sit. No, hold. Pick that up, dude, come on, hold. No, hold. Sit. Come here, sit. Sit. Koshka, knock it off, hold it, sit. Sit. Drop. He's a dominant dog. What are you going to do? Come here, heel. No, heel. No, heel. Sit. Right? I got to give him negativity. He's got to know that I'm serious about this shit. You can't just let your dog do whatever and just give up. If they give you a refusal, don't just give up. You got to stick with it. But, you know, and obviously, you know, it might take a little bit of extra time to get the dog compliant. But when they're compliant, they're, you know, you're starting to shape them in the direction you want them to go. He's still really young. He's still just over a year, right? And he's got a shitload of puppy energy, and his breed is, you know, notorious for being like shitheads kind of when they're young. So it is what it is. And I mean, like, but he loves doing retrieves. And if I, obviously he's already been running around out here while I was doing some yard work. So a little bit of his energy has already been expended. But, you know, the basic idea is essentially just, you have to exercise your dog, but you also need to train them, right? And honestly, by training your dog, you are exercising them, right? And again, it's perfect for the lazy dog owner. Like, if you're a dog owner and you don't want to go for a fucking hour-long walk every day, right, which I don't want to do that every day, you know what I mean? But you teach your dog to retrieve, you know what I mean? You can teach your dog to retrieve in a month, you know, or maybe not in a month, but, well, actually, yeah, in about a month you can teach your dog to retrieve, right? Then, you know, your problem of having to go on long walks is solved. I mean, last night, what I did is I, you know, didn't have the time to go take my dog for a 45-minute walk. So I went and took him out into the field right over here, and I threw some retrieves for him, and he hauled ass back, to get the retrieve and bring it back to me. And then, you know, and then he just got exercised. It took like 5 minutes. It took 5 minutes, and he was beat. He fell asleep for like 6 hours, right? A young dog like this, who's, you know, they're supposed to be shitheads, right? But he was just out. He was being calm. He was chilling out in his crate, and he wasn't, you know, he was just asleep. And that's the thing, is like, it's weird that this doesn't really occur to people. They don't really understand, like, oh, I don't need to train my dog. I'll just let him do whatever. And then, you know, their dog doesn't get proper exercise either. It's like, what, do you never exercise your dog? That's ridiculous. Your dog should get exercise. It's important. But they should also get training. And the reason you don't want to exercise your dog is because they're fucking annoying. So you have to train them to not be annoying. And then when they're not annoying, then it's fun to exercise them. Right? Now, Koshka, knock it off. No. Hey, knock it off. No. 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 Get over here. Koshka, come here. Get over here right now. Sit. Come here and heal. Sit. Right? He knows I'm not fucking around. Right? He saw a squirrel. But it's okay. He's in the yard. And he's young, so he's got a high prey drive. But, you know, that's another thing, is he has a high prey drive for the ball. Right? So if I were to tell him to sit, and then I were to have him go for a retrieve, then, you know... But that's just something that I wanted to talk about. This might have been going on for a long amount of time or whatever, but I just wanted to kind of, I felt like I should talk about this because it's just something that goes, like I said, I mean, like, I was talking to my friend for a long time, and he's like a friend of Cesar Millan, or not a friend, but he's a fan of Cesar Millan, and he thought, you know, that, oh, like, oh, what, exercise is so important, it's so important. And then I explained to him, like, you can exercise your dog just by telling them to lay down and sit back up. That's doing a push-up, basically, for the dog. And he's like, what? You can exercise your dog without taking them for a walk? And it was, like, surprising to him. You know, and it's just like, yeah, you can. You can exercise your dog without taking them for a walk. You can exercise your dog just by having them lay down. Close, go down. No, down. Down. Knock it off. Down. Good boy. Close, go sit. Close, go down. No, down. No, lay down. Down. No, lay down. Hey, Koshka, pay attention, man, lay down. Come here and heal. Heal the right way, come on. Down. Lay down. Down. Good, good boy. There's multiple reasons why he doesn't want to lay down. You know what I mean? He's a dominant type of dog. Two, it is exercise for him to lay down. He's using his muscles to do it. And then not only that, but the ground is wet here and it's muddy, and he's kind of, you know, a little princess about stuff. So he doesn't want to lay down in the dirt. Right. And it's like, well, I told you lay down. You got to lay down, buddy. So, yeah. But that's the thing, is like, you know, exercise your dogs, train your dogs. You should be doing both. Training probably has a higher priority than exercise. But that's the thing, is when you do train your dog, you also exercise them. You exercise their mind and their body, right? And that's so crucial. It's so important, right? Especially just for having, you know, I mean, like, your dog shouldn't be locked in a house all day. Your dog also shouldn't be out in the backyard all day, right? Having your dog in a kennel for a certain period of time during the day is fine also, right? If you exercise your dog like hell for 10 minutes, you're having them do retrieves for 10 minutes and they're fucking hauling ass to the retrieve and then hauling ass back. They're sprinting, exercising, you know what I mean? So much. They're just, imagine if you ran across the field and then ran back across the field, right? You'd be beat. You'd be tuckered out, most likely. You'd be pretty tired at that, at the end of that, I imagine. And then sitting in a room for an hour doesn't seem like that big of a deal. If anything, you're happy because now you get to chill out. That's the kind of the same philosophy with the dog. People think that having a dog in a kennel for 45 minutes is like the worst. It's like, oh God, the dog's in the kennel for 45 minutes. It's like, it's not that big of a deal if they got exercise beforehand. If they're stuck in the kennel all day and they're never exercised, then yeah, that's ridiculous. But if they're, you know, if you exercise them in and out of the kennel, you know what I mean? They're in the kennel for 45 minutes. You take them and exercise them for 20 minutes. In the kennel for 45 minutes. Exercise them for 20 minutes. That's totally fine. It's totally acceptable. And they don't even mind. They don't even care. My dog loves the kennel. That's like his safe space, man. There's times he's being a dickhead inside and then he starts, you know, hearing me. I'm saying, hey, no, knock it off, you know what I mean? And then his default is to go back into the kennel because he's like, all right, when I'm in here, I'm being good. You know, and that's the thing. It's like, he loves the kennel, right? It's not like jail for him. They don't ponder thought like that. They don't think of it as like prison, you know? But, yeah, that's all I really have to say about the matter. I'm Desmond Snow Dog Training. I'm a dog trainer in the Pacific Northwest area. You can contact me at 360-991-4392. My email address is desmondsnow@gmail.com. If anybody has any questions about dogs or exercising or training, about the methodology of any of this stuff, right? And you might be like, oh, well, you know, your dog was hesitant to lay down. It's like, yeah, he's off leash. Normally he's on a leash. If I had him on the leash, you bet your sweet ass that he'd be hauling ass to lay down and stand up and shit, right? But it's transitional, you know what I mean? And I wanted to practice having him off leash out here and see how he does. And he's doing okay, maybe not the best. If he was completely non-compliant, then I would put the leash on him. That's why I have the leash around my neck right now. But anyways, I'm gonna wrap it up before I go on and on. But yeah, Desmond Snow Dog Training. Contact me if you have any questions or if you need your dog trained. Yeah, we could probably work something out. I have pretty flexible rates and stuff, so yeah, but hope you guys have a good day. Hope you guys get out there and train your dogs, for God's sake. They need training and exercise. But when you train your dog, you also exercise them most of the time. So, you know, they're doing reps, they're doing push-ups and stuff. So, yeah, hope you guys have a good day, and I will see you guys in the next video.